when I was a kid, I would have, like, I'm not gonna get into it, because it's kind of weird.
No, get it, like, no, say it, what?
No, just, like, actual OCD things, oh, like, yeah.
Whatever. We all have those, though. It's we say OCD in a general sense, but I think everybody has things like that, where they're, like, just weird little things that they overthink. Anyways, here's the sneaky snake. I'll try not to die, but if I do die, you'll see.
You said you couldn't die.
No, I mean, not die. Like, literally, what I meant was, like, the status affliction thing where he turns you into the egg and, like, it makes you just restart the boss battle. And then what's annoying is you don't instantly get to restart it. He goes... I did that really quickly, actually.
Dude, I'm the same way in Kirby Magic Mirror. I, like, know how to, like, get the bosses in the first 3 seconds.
Yeah. No, like... I don't want to, like, suck my own dick, but I'm, like, actually good at this game. Like, this is one of the games I grew up with. Like, I'm actually good at it. Why did it end early? I must have hit the thing. Okay, this is going to be a complete crapshoot at this point. It was 9 twice in a row. Okay. Kind of rude. I just freaking cracked my whole wrist. Anyways. I guess Sinom has OCD.
No, can you cut that part out real?
Yeah.
Okay. I'm insecure about it.
You're insecure. Don't know what fur. It's something with the brush. I got the
buzz. Boots with the fur.
The boots with the fur. Everybody is. I'm trying to do it on beat with the song. Looking at her. Okay, it's not working. And these cutscenes are great. I don't know. It's fun. Look, he's got a super tricep or something. It's weird. I never really understood what the animation was supposed to be.
Wait, for the next one we do, can I play Kirby Magic Mirror?
Yeah. I have to download it. What's that for again?
GBA.
Okay, yeah, super easy. The only annoying thing is obviously you have to figure out the keys. Like,
right.
And Game Boy games are super easy because it's always just 2 buttons.
Right.
Anything past that is annoying.
I love Game Boy.
Same. This level's really funny.
What's your favorite Nintendo console?
Oh, probably... that's so hard, though. I was gonna say Game Boy Color for sure, but then obviously, like, I love the GameCube, too, and GameCube has, like, so many classics.
Okay, to be fair to you, you can pick one, like, console and one handheld device.
Okay, then probably just those two, because I never had a Game Boy Advance until way later, and I never had a DS. So I literally just grew up with Game Boy Color.
Did you have, like, a little lamp?
Okay. No, what I would do is I would hold a flashlight in my mouth if I was at night, or I would get up really early. And like, this is why I think waking up early is nostalgic, because it's specifically tied to like having a Game Boy and wanting to have the perfect like lighting or whatever. Damn it.
I know you don't think about these things because you're like, a screen is like a screen, right?
Yeah,
but
yeah.
Like, I have the Game Boy Advance and I had like...
That has backlight.
It has backlight, but it's still like really shitty. So,
oh, okay.
Like, I had like an external lamp that I could plug into my Game Boy that would like... It was like a little reading lamp, but for my Game Boy.
That's funny. They made ones like that specifically that you would attach to it.
Right, that exactly.
Oh, that's what you're talking about.
Right.
Okay, that's
it's
funny.
Like,
I thought you meant, like, a separate
thing.
You, like,
thing. Plugged it into
that's
the Game Boy.
That's so funny. What the fuck? Oh, that's so annoying.
What I didn't have, but I really wanted, was the Game Boy camera.
Oh, my God. So, I follow an account on Instagram literally just called, like, Game Boy Camera or something. And it's this guy who's just super obsessed with taking photographs with, like, a Game Boy camera.
I think it's, like, fucking, like, amazing. And then it comes with the printer, and then you print out
yeah.
your pictures.
Yeah! See, growing up with the Game Boy, though, I was always sad because, obviously, I didn't have a Game Boy printer. And a lot, Nintendo being Nintendo, is super gimmicky with every game they've ever made. So, there's so many things built into, like, Pokemon and I can't think of other ones, but a lot of games would
the
have
Game
stuff.
The Game Boy camera was the... original amiibo.
Yeah, exactly. No, it really was, if you think about it, right? Like, that's actually true. So there were things where, oh, and in Link's Awakening there's the little like purple mouse photographer guy.
Oh, right.
And you can print those photos that he takes of you throughout the game as actual photos, which is crazy, right? Like, you have little actual screenshots from a thing that wasn't capable of having screenshots, you know what I mean? Like, that's nuts.
Yeah.
Whatever. Anyways, I'm skipping that. Earth. Anyways. Oh, okay, see, here, I just murdered him. Oh, see, so you see this penguin guy right here? See how he's like a ball? So in the Japanese version, because the Japanese versions are always a little raunchier, especially with Game Boy games, which makes me laugh, than the American versions. So in a lot of Pokemon games, like, certain sprites would have their titties out, like, a little more, like, as far as, like, a girl in a bikini or, like, shorter skirts or stuff like that. And then in the American version, they would literally, because sprites are easy to edit, probably change that to make them have longer skirts or cover cleavage or do whatever. So it's literally the same thing. So the reason these guys have these weird balls is because it's supposed to be a beer can, and they throw beer at you and it makes you drunk, which is that status affliction that you saw where he gets all pink and then my controls get really wonky. They're like reversed. So I have to press like right to go left and left to go right or whatever. Which is hilarious. So yeah, those are, yeah, look, so it's like that. And then I have to like lean and it's super annoying. Oh, I didn't, what? Okay, that's hilarious. I forgot you can shoot out like burps. I forgot that was a thing. Anyways, and the music's all funny. And like out of tune. That's so great. This is a good game. Anyways. Wait, I just came in here. What am I doing? Yeah. Anyways, did you get your thing posted?
Yeah.
Okay. Where am I supposed... Oh, I'm... There we go. What the fuck am I doing? There we go. Jeez. People get really annoyed about that. I love watching Oni plays. They're like... any gaming channel, and if somebody burps, all the comments are like, don't do that! It's like, right in the mic! It's like, okay? Do you really mind that much? Ah, I fucked that up, whatever. Okay, so these rolling down the hill thing, I couldn't beat this level forever as a kid. Literally, just that, and then you beat the level. I didn't know how to do that for the longest time as a kid, so I was like, how the fuck do you get to the other side? Like, I couldn't figure it out that you're supposed to hold down while you're on the hill. Even though they literally give you a thing that shows you that the first time you do it, which is so funny. Like, that's such a great thing about old games, too, is, like, not having gaming manuals and actually having to figure stuff out like that on your own.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Did you have any games like that where you, like, just couldn't beat it? But it was, like, something super simple. You come back to it later and it's like, oh my god, like, what am I doing? I feel like...
I feel like...
What?
I'm thinking.
Because I know you said you had your dad beat stuff, but I feel like that's different. That's like, if it's hard, you have your dad come in and like help you beat it.
Right.
It's not like something where it's a...
No, I would let my dad do like boss battles. And
yeah, stuff. That's what I'm saying, right? But it's something so different when it's like something you literally can't figure out. Kelp Forest is a good example in the Battle for Bikini Bottom game. That whole Kelp Cave like section of that level is just like really weird backtracky puzzles that Dave and I would literally just sit there and grind and try to figure out, like, which was hilarious. Like, I have this really funny memory of him just being like, okay, so obviously you're having a hard time with this, we're gonna switch off, you're gonna clean the room while I figure it out, and then we'll switch and I'll clean the rest and you. Because it's just like, I mean, again, looking back at it, I go back and I can beat that level. It's nothing. But at the time, it was just like, we literally had no idea how to genuinely do it. Because it's like, okay, so you shoot this missile at this button, and then you have to go back, and you have to redo it, and you have to go do this, and just, I don't know, super funny. What?
Sorry, I'm like brain dead. Right
now. That's fine. We're tired. We can go to bed in a sec.
It's 2 a.m.
I know. These eels are, you just have to speed past them. They drag you. That's another thing, too, where it's just like, yeah, look, it doesn't kill you, but you lose coins, and then it makes you redo the whole section. That's like half of this game. We're gonna fake him out. Yeah, bitch! Shoobity shoobity. That's the noise it makes. Shoobity shoobity. Dee 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 dee.
The face he makes.
That guy's still trying to throw shit at me. Okay, let's freaking wrap this up. What? Okay, I guess we're playing this. Again, I am hitting the wrong buttons. Oh shit, I bet it's one. Oh, what the fuck?